Welcome back to Furuno Connections. Today is the final testing of the side scanning sonars, and we're going into some really shallow water. We're talking 15 to 20 feet of water, and this is really where those high frequency side scanning sonars should shine. However, I will tell you that we were really impressed with the DFF 3D's performance in shallow water. You know, the DFF 3D is well known for its deep water performance, but I think you're going to be pleasantly surprised with just how well it performed compared to the competitors. Pay close attention to how it displays the cigar minnows compared to the competitors. I think you're going to be really impressed. We're going to finish off the episode with one final tip on the DFF 3D. We're going to show you how to drop a mark directly from the DFF 3D's screen so that you can always go back to it. So sit back, relax, and enjoy this final testing of the side scanning sonars.
So right here, we're going over an old barge, and we're in 19, 20 feet of water here, and it's gonna mark up pretty good. It comes up pretty high. It's gonna be right over here on our right, and here it comes right there. That's a great picture for it. We're gonna save that one. Still finding bait on the outside of it.
So even in 20 feet of water, the DFF 3D still does a darn good job of showing that kind of information.
Yeah.
And side to side as well. Right here, we're going over this structure in 17, 15 feet of water. It's popping on that 3D history page. It's popping on the side scan. You can see it easily in the cross section and also in the 3D downsounder mode. You know, it's really nice. And you know, you convinced me, we can see everything from cigar minnows to deep water, you know, fish at 1,000 feet. It's amazing. So, you know, so the DFF 3D really does a great job all around. You know, there's really no limitations. We may not be able to see a pipe or maybe the porthole, but we can see all the fish we're gonna catch and all the fish we need to catch to catch those fish. So it's really nice.
Well, what I wanted to capture there, actually, what that showed on the 3D, It showed, because I dived this spot, so I know how it's laid out. It showed every little rib that was in there.
Okay, right.
And that you're not gonna find on there.
Right.
And I wanna go back over one more time and go over that, because that's what it did show, was every little rib that's
right
in there.
Exactly.
And that
right
is how it is.
Yeah.
So this right here was a testament.
Like a true presentation.
Of the wreck, exactly
the wreck.
How it
yeah,
is.
Exactly,
yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
I know you said don't see the porthole, but guess what? It showed every rib that
which
was
is
in
really,
there.
And when you're serious about fishing, that's the kind of information you need. You don't need to see a porthole or, you know, or individual, you know, windows in a ship. You need to see fish, you need to see bait, you need to see what you're gonna catch. Little pops.
The way
right
this
there,
wreck is, these are the ribs, you know,
wow,
all right
huge
here.
Yep. That's huge.
Yep, so that's
I can
definitely
totally see that that's exactly how it looks, yeah.
Yep. That's how it lays
right
out.
We
too
got a good shot of it here,
yeah,
too.
And here goes
that,
it.
That makes sense, yeah.
See?
That totally
that's a
makes
great,
sense.
Yeah. Great.
Yeah, I'm thinking one more shot of
yep
it.
Yep, yeah. There it is right there. We're sitting
yeah, so
right on
even
top
in 15 feet of water, the DFF 3D still gives us a pretty damn good presentation.
Yeah.
Amazing, actually.
Yeah, and 15
you know,
feet's going to be on top.
Right.
The, around it's going to be 20,
20,
so we're
still,
right on top.
Yeah, so,
there's going to be a need and want for everything. You know,
mm-hmm.
This may relate to somebody better than what this would,
mm-hmm.
but you know, everybody's each their own.
Yeah, exactly.
But with the Furuno TZT3, you got it all.
Yeah.
You got four screens there
yeah
to choose
exactly
from.
Yeah.
So you can do it. You can swipe this over here to your left, make it nice and clean.
Yeah. Really nice.
Really see it.
All right, so yeah, here we are at 22.6 feet, and man, what a difference. Tim, what do you think?
Absolutely, I mean, now we're still set up on 455 kilohertz on both the down and side scan, and definitely a lot more detail in the shallower water at that higher frequency, and we also still have medium chirp on the screen as well. So yeah, we're getting really good detail. It was definitely worth making the trip to even shallower water just to see the performance of this thing.
Right.
What do you think, Mike?
Well, I gotta say, it's, you know, we came from about 112 from the last spot and it was still marking fairly clear. This is definitely marking clear, but it's not far off, even in that deeper water.
Yeah, I mean, no, good point.
It's,
yeah,
it's
yeah.
really not.
Yeah, good point. No, I mean, you're getting pretty much, I mean, pretty much the same detail.
Pretty spot on.
Yeah, so you can clearly see the detail and the target separation, especially on the right-hand side there. I mean, yeah. this looks pretty impressive.
Okay, we've been out here pretty much all day testing these fish finders. I think we're at our last spot. Where have you brought us today?
Yeah, so we've come into the shallow reef about 20 feet, and there's an old barge, work barge out here on the bottom.
Okay.
Kind of roll over here and see if we can mark it up.
All right, great. So now we're in about 20, 25 feet of water. I really expect this down scan and side scan to give us a really good picture and give us a lot of information about what fish are down there and what side of the boat this structure is on when we go by it. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna take a look at the screen when we go over the wreck, and we're gonna show you what we see. All right, here on System C, what we're doing is we're seeing our same four-way split, and we're getting a real nice image out of that side scan. We're really getting a good bottom image on this down scan, and our high frequency sonar is showing us that structure and showing us the fish hanging around with it. Unfortunately, I'm not too sure what the 3D is doing right now, but we do have a lot of good information out of our side scan and our down scan and our high frequency sonar in these types of depths. So as we can see with System C, these units are going to be most effective in these shallower waters, this 20 feet, you know, 80 feet, 100 feet, you know, even out to 200, we were marking some fish. You know, they're running at a much higher frequency, so I would expect them to do really well in these shallow waters and, you know, maybe struggle a little bit in those deeper waters. You know, that's why with our DFF 3D multi-beam sonar, we kept it to 165 kilohertz. Because in these shallow waters, you're going to be able to see those fish. You're going to be able to tell that there's structure down there. But when you get out deeper, you're also going to be able to utilize that 120 degree beam and get a lot of information. Now, I know, Cam, you've had a chance to interact with the DFF 3D multi-beam sonar. You know, what is your take on using that in deeper water and, you know, kind of information you can get?
Yeah, so that most definitely is a thing that you want to use in deeper water like we did today out on the Humps.
Mm-hmm.
It was very good for reading the bottom for electric reel fishing. Also very good for fishing for the tunas, which might be a couple hundred feet down in the thermal incline,
mm-hmm.
off to the sides and whatnot, but it'll tell you where they are in that deep water, which is very effective.
And that's excellent. You know, Cam brings up a good point looking at tuna and fish in the water column. You know, just because you may be in deeper water than the DFF 3D multi-beam can read, you know, maybe we're fishing in 1,000, we're in a couple thousand feet. We can still utilize that product and look at a big swath of the water column and see where tuna are. You know, we have guys that can see where the marlin are in the thermoclines. So it definitely can be a very useful tool whether you're in shallow or you're out in the deep.
Check out this spot right here, Eric. So if I just tap on that, brings up there, I want to hit a new point. And you know, I catch a lot of snappers here. So let's see here, we're gonna identify it.
Going to the catch mode, the new yep. DFF 3D catch mode.
And you see really everything that they have here. And so I'm gonna label it snapper. I get a lot of mutton snappers here.
And when you bring it up, if you bring up some, you could boom, log
and put
the
it
weight
on there.
And log the length of the fish. It's
so really I can cool. say, okay, like that snapper was 0.30 inches.
Yeah.
All right, got it. And the weight, say 1.6 pounds.
Check mark.
Got it.
You got it.
And hit okay.
Yeah, and that'll log it into the machine, and then we can download that to the cloud later.
And then right there is my fish mark.
Yeah. Looks like a snapper, too.
It's like a snapper. That's awesome, man. Yeah. That's something new, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, it's totally new.
Yeah, I don't remember having that on my TZT2.
No, it wasn't on TZT2. Just added it to TZT3. With this, Captain, you could even take a picture of that fish and log it into the new Furuno First Mate app, and it'll automatically save the picture, and you can even post it later on social media, no problem.
Awesome.
Really cool.
Well, that wraps up our testing for the DFF 3D and side scanning sonar. If you joined us for the last three episodes, you've seen us test in shallow, mid-level, and deep water, and I'm pretty sure that you are just as impressed as we are with the performance of the DFF 3D. We understand that it requires a black box and a transducer to operate the DFF 3D, but it truly is the only side-scanning sonar system that can go from 20 feet to 1,000 feet of water and still show the bottom structure and fish targets. If you're serious about fishing and you want to know which side of the boat to throw your lines, The DFF 3D is the tool you need. On the next episode, we go back to the captains and crew to get their experiences and opinions on the DFF 3D and the other side scanning systems. So make sure you join us on the next episode of Furuno Connections. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you like, subscribe, and click on the bell below to get notifications for the next time we release new videos. Thanks a lot, and we'll see you next time.